Keteke is embarking on a humanitarian trip to Otabokrom and other surrounding villages in the central region. The main objective of this trip is to help impact on the lives of these people, these needy people in Otabokrom and the other villages. While we are there, we will be offering donations to them, clothes, shoes, pens, pencils, books. And while we are there, we will also impact on them emotionally, because we'll be offering them teaching services in their basic schools, and we'll also be counseling them on several important issues.
Keteke Ghana, a student-led campus initiative to empower journalism students to be active agents of change, embarks on its maiden trip with a purpose, a trip that runs on the wheels of love and selflessness. Motivated by the desire to reach out and extend a supporting hand to marginalized communities, the Keteke team is poised to give the little they can give to see change and progress in these communities. The team arrives at Ogwa Hall of the University of Cape Coast, where they will be housed for the next 7 days. Everyone settles into their respective rooms, and some were too tired to feature on our cameras.
It's been fun and tiring. And I want to sleep right now, so please let me sleep.
The Keteke trip will be leaving to the village to cover the whole story about the village, how they live, their daily lifestyle, and what they do, so that Keteke too, as humanitarians, will know what to do to help them benefit as villagers.
The crew leaves for Otabokrom, a little over an hour's drive from the UCC campus. The bus faces a few obstacles on the way, but for the help of a good Samaritan on the road path to Otabokrom, our bus gets its way through the narrow road. Safe and sound, the team arrives in the community and prepares to achieve the objectives for the day in the village. The team meets the village elders and opinion leaders who share how life is in the village and the challenges therein.
Community bi anasua bi ni ehwe na ebetimi aboa ama oman no akoso and in our own in yaya small way enye se bibi kesi bi ba ya bibi kitu e bi a pese e ye deboa ni ntie sesi e hunsa nke e ba ni abetra de ai nimbie kakare nimbie wo no ni emfa mbe ma enu anom kitu a omwo otibokro nti ye ba ye ba ya ye ba se abetra de ni aboa otibofo kakra.
Yeah, what? Be brave. And what do you hear? If you say, young colleague, what teacher is school? You need a teacher for paper, do what e binum why e wo hu to hu ache no wa de boa e bi se mo so ma ba na mo yi ye ho do na mo se mo be boa an e bi ya yesu ye jitum ye damase enti yesu asida hu ye de mam.
As the professional requirements and ethics of journalism demand, the team seeks permission from the elders to use their recording devices in the community, a move that builds trust, confidence, and respect between journalists and their subjects.
Cameras, Ninyoma, yeah, Pama Chose, you bet to me, a pictures,
one of the teams responsible for teaching and counseling inspires the children and ignites their dreams of a better life ahead if they took learning seriously.
Again.
The team meets an aggrieved woman who pours out her heart on the difficulties the community goes through on a daily basis. Daniel Deborah, a volunteer teacher in Otterbochrome, shares the challenges they face as far as education in the community is concerned.
But the problem we are facing is the seniors or the parents here and the audience here, they are not allowed the kids to go to school, especially on the Mondays, or on the Tuesdays and the Friday, which is the market day of our community.
He narrates how children are engaged on the cocoa farms during each cocoa season.
The cocoa season, they use them to the cocoa farm and then they carry cocoa for the parents. Instead of being paying money to the others to come and carry, they say, oh, if they use the money, it means the part of the money is that going. So they have to use the kids and then carry the load. And it is very hard work indeed. Small kids, like from about 6 years to 9 years, they do these jobs.
Daniel Deborah's exhibition of selflessness and dedication to assisting the children of Otterbochrome with some of their educational needs is remarkable, given that the meager salaries he receives do not make him quit, but rather he farms to support himself in order to support the pupils.
As for me, I'm living in the community, and I also work from here to that distance previous days, and I was not able to get somebody to assist me, so I'm living here. So I do farm. So early in the morning, I go to the farm, and they come early and then support the kids.
In spite of several interventions to reduce child labor and eliminate its worst forms, local communities that are usually poor literally push children into child labor. Prevailing cultural and economic circumstances may have kept the children working and risking their health, education, and well-being. The United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child, the International Labor Organization Convention 182, and the Children's Act of Ghana are key international and national conventions and legislative frameworks that seek to protect children from economic abuse and help eliminate the worst forms of child labor. At Otterbochrome, the situation on child labor, according to some community members, have improved, yet there is still more work to be done. Some of the children pluck coconuts for sale, whilst others assist their parents on the farm, according to some inhabitants, sometimes during school hours. Otterbochrome has several development challenges. The community relies on water from a nearby stream during the rainy season and has to rely on a river That is almost 2 hours of walk away because the nearby stream dries up in the dry season. After all the hard work, the Keteke team retires to the Ogwa Hall for the day's evaluation and planning for the following day. Teaching and counseling team continue their work. They take their pupils through some basic lessons. The team brought sacks and pieces of cloth and a cobbler's needle to creatively design doormats.
Make carpets, like doormats. Okay, the normal doormats. Now we had to use a resource that if we're no more here, they could easily get. So you use sack, cocoa sack, which I'm sure they should have here. And then pieces of old material, cuts, just putting them through and then tying them like a knot. It's no much work. So later they can do it and then sell, or they can do it and use in their homes.
In the meantime, Obusian Penny Mensah, a cocoa farmer and an opinion leader, speaks on the sanitation situation in Otobokrom. On a health-related subject, the team meets a traditional birth attendant who explains how they handle health emergencies. The team turns to a young man who narrates how life is without electricity.
Students as a whole crowd. So we need lighter. You will find it difficult. Say, what day can be a normal lantern in the crown? We should not need pursue. And also, the rate of carriage in our orbit tunnel and also very expensive. Right now, the fuel prices have been increased in Ghana, and also expensive. Now, if you are the hospital, I'm going to be here, light, now I will put it. For the operation, put a higher class, I'm fine on cocoa. But light to her, we'll be fish or baba be a juma. For instance, I see what's clinic, we'll be baba.
I came in yesterday, I realized these kids or these children don't have any knowledge about their country and some similar, the basic things that the country is doing for them. So I start by letting them know, because I realized they are having their main farming here is with cocoa, and they don't know even the one who brought cocoa to Ghana. So I started with that, letting them know the one who brought cocoa to Ghana. And today I'm trying to help them how to recite a poem with the title Ghana. The poem goes by Ghana, Ghana, Ghana. Ghana is my country. Okay. And they are trying to pick it up. I'm really grateful because they don't know us. They don't know me, but they are trying to cooperate with me, and they are trying very hard.
Thank you.
necessary we teach them numbers and then alphabets, because that's the basis for their learning. It's where the learning all begins, you understand? But then you realize in teaching these ones from preschool up to like class four, you need a balance. They need to really understand what they are learning. So we do it 80% in the local language and then 20% in English. So there's a balance, but then we really need them to understand. That's why we do it 80%. Then from class four till maybe class six, you do it 50-50, English, local language. And then just as you can see, go with English.